What just happened?
There's the sigil.
Could it be that I would need second chance and once more? Quickly! Bring out the balloons! Hit stun does not work on him. Why are you so more flippy-dippy than last time? Don't make me summon the Ragnarok! That's it. You've asked for it. You've asked for Ragnarok! He asked for the Ragnarok. Quickly, balloons! Xemnas does not like balloons! I don't know anyone that likes balloons. Oh, buildings. I'm just hating the balloon. He has a lot more flippy-dippy tricks than last time. Nope. Help. I will kill you with balloons, good sir. Can we do the Ragnarok? Aw, man! I wanted to do the Ragnarok! That actually did a lot of damage to him. And glossary, the Reclusant Sigil. That's basically the X on the clothing that we've been seeing all series.
You... again.
You just make it too easy. I know you think you've won, but you lost the moment you dived this far in. You're in the deepest pit of slumber, and you've worn yourself down to nothing. There's no returning to the world above.
What do you mean?
We told you. It was not the sleeping keyholes that guided you. They are not the reason you are here. You've been on a path. One we laid out for you. That sigil on your chest is the proof.
What?
See, that sigil, the X, it tells us where you are at all times. You had wondered aloud before why we kept showing up where you were. It's because we need you, Sora. Or, to be more precise, we need what will be left of you. The 13th Dark Vessel.
Why... I...
Why was it assured you would come here today? Because I followed my destined path, and I'm here looking at you right now. You can move through time, but time itself is immovable. Today, all of my selves throughout time were meant to gather here and to welcome you, Sora, as our 13th member. These facts cannot be changed.
What's gonna happen?
I have now told you all that I know. We are all here, and what the future holds in store is beyond my sight. I will return to my own time and grow into the man who becomes all these others. While I know this future now that I have lived it, returning to my own time will erase the memories and experiences I have gained here. Still, my appointed path is now etched in my heart, which will first lead me to seek the outside world.
Riku.
Your heart will sleep forever in the folds of darkness, and your body will be another vessel for me. So light gives way to darkness. Good night, Sora.
And Hearts Tied to Sora, a glossary of entry that discusses the many hearts connected to Sora's. Spoiler alert, it's pretty much everyone in the series. Like, pretty much everyone in the series. So, as you can see, the drop meter is gone now. We are at the point where, for one, we are at the point of no return. For two, I wonder... Yeah, that's right. I was fighting Xemnas this whole time. So now, nothing new will happen. I don't even think we can actually change worlds. Yeah, we are at the point of no return. So, it's time to go and tackle the end of this game.
End of the road, huh? I know I'm back in the real world, but I still have my Dream Eater powers. Which means he still hasn't woken up. Where are you, Sora? Dream Eater.
Oh, hey.
Is that where Sora is? How do I get across? Right. I get it.
And... this is to take you to the final area of the game. So, let's ride. I love how Plopper and Flip Flap showed up.
Off my new vessel.
Vessel?
Yes. We originally had our sights set on you, but you developed a certain resistance to darkness. So we did what the Keyblade did and moved down the list. Roxas. Now there was a worthy candidate. But unfortunately, he became too aware of himself and returned to Sora. Organization 13's true goal is to divide Xehanort's heart among 13 vessels. Thanks to you and Sora, we learned not all our candidates were fit for the task, but we managed to make up the difference. And now, Sora, the 13th vessel, is within our grasp.
13 Xehanorts? What is...
the real Organization 13.
The Organization?
I am Xehanort from the most distant past. My future self gave me a task. To visit the splintered versions of myself in many worlds. And ensure they gathered here today.
From the past?
There are restrictions to movement through time. First, you must leave your body behind to do it. Then, there must be a version of you waiting at the destination. Upon arrival, you can only move forward as per the laws of time. And you cannot rewrite the events that are destined to happen.
What have you done?
My most future self will arrive soon. Then time for all of us will return to normal. And I will go back to my era to live the life fate has in store. He can vouch for that.
I'm glad I'm not too late.
Mickey!
Just grab Sora so we can go. I can't stop them for long.
Okay.
Mickey!
I said hands off!
How can you be moving?
Oh, oh no! Are you?
Be gone!
Oh boy. So, it's time we beat up young Xehanort. You know what they say. Oh, I should have changed out. In hindsight. Yo, buddy, pal, friend. Oh god, I'm getting flashbacks. I must have touched the ground. Wow. That wasn't in the script. Balloons! Stop teleporting.
Time stop.
Thunder.
No, 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 no. Help, he's super aggressive. Balloons! Away.
Heal. Yeah. Freeze. Fire. Fire.
Stupid mysterious figure. Mysterious figure. Heal. Bullshit.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
You shall wander forever.
Second verse, same as the first. God, you're a spammer. Balloons. Okay, gonna healy dealy. Okay. Okay, let's try this again. Help. Help. Yeah. Balloons! Yeah. Freeze. Fire.
Thunder! Heal!
Yeah. Balloons! Oh boy. Gotta be quick on the updraw. There we go. That beats young Xehanort. I wanted to beat him with balloons, but at this point, I don't want him to healy-deely. I can't believe I brute forced that.
Are you okay, Riku?
Yeah. Thanks, Mickey.
What did Mickey do?
Oh, Master Xehanort! Huh? We were right about you!
All of this was decided. My 12 selves would welcome me here on this day. And I would return a complete person. It is the future which lies beyond my sight.
Why are you doing this?
In ancient times, people believed that light was a gift from an unseen land by the name of Kingdom Hearts. But Kingdom Hearts was safeguarded by its counterpart, the Keyblade. Warriors vied for that precious light, thus beginning the Keyblade War. The violent clash shattered the Keyblade into 20 pieces, 7 of light and 13 of darkness. And the only real Kingdom Hearts was swallowed by the darkness, never to surface again. I once tried to create my own pure light and darkness to forge the Keyblade, but the attempt ended in failure. In my eagerness, I had lost sight of the correct way to achieve my goal. I acted rashly. I can admit that now.
What you did back then? Your mistakes? change the destinies of three of my friends.
Ah, but destiny is never left to chance. I merely guided them to their proper places. The broken boy who failed to be the blade. The misguided master who sacrificed herself for a friend. And the feckless youth who became my new vessel.
I couldn't find a way to save them. But I wanted to believe that their sacrifice stopped you for good. Why? How was I so blind? I should have seen it as soon as Maleficent started gathering the seven princesses of heart.
Yes. They were all my doing. I used the evil fairy to find seven pure lights for me. Just as I prepared 13 vessels to fill with pure darkness.
But you failed. Sora stopped you in your tracks on both counts.
Yes, he did. That dull, ordinary boy. A Keyblade wielder so unlike any I have ever seen. However, I have not abandoned my ambitions. The seven guardians of light and the 13 seekers of darkness.
Seven guardians of light? Well, for Keyblade wielders, there's me and Riku and Sora, and my three missing friends, that's six. Then the seventh would be... Oh, that means the 13 seekers of darkness.
Yes, little king. Perceptive. But Sora and another on your list belong to me now. And that puts you three guardians short. But worry not. All of the pieces are destined to appear. Your seven lights, just like my 13 darknesses, whose final clash will beget the prize I seek.
The Keyblade!
But first, the 13 darknesses shall be united. All the seats have been filled. And now, the last vessel shall bear my heart like the rest.
No!
Sora! No!
Axel, please. The name's Lee. Got it memorized?
You're not supposed to be here.
Promises to keep. I'll always be there to get my friends back. What? Bad timing? You had your perfect little script, but you kind of forgot to write the sequel. Now, let's find out what happens.
What now, you old coot? Our time is up!
Aiza!
Why are you here, Axel?
No, I told you my name's... Whatever. Axel. Fine. Now let's get out of here.
Right!
Hmm?
supposed to do that?
I think so.
Goofy, Donald, you saved us.
We are out of time. Neither the union of light nor darkness has been achieved. We must all return whence we came. But the gathering of the 7 and 13 is nigh. Let us finish this at the fated place, once your lights and my darknesses have joined together.
Seven lights, 13 darknesses. Master Xehanort has been busy.
Aw, Sora. Don't tell me your heart's sleeping too.
No, Mickey. This affliction is not the same.
Can we do anything for him?
Yeah.
In your Mark of Mastery exam, you were to unlock 7 sleeping keyholes. By doing so, you would awaken those worlds from their prison of slumber, and also acquire the power to free a heart from its sleep. Riku, you unlocked those keyholes within Sora's dreams. Therefore, it stands to reason that you now have the power to awaken Sora's heart.
You want him to dive back into Sora's sleep? But, Master, Sora's heart is down in the darkest abyss. If Riku's not careful, he might just get trapped down there with him. No, I'll go instead.
And perhaps you may even succeed, Mickey. But there is no denying Riku stands the better chance, having dived into Sora's heart as long as he has.
Mickey, I really appreciate it, but I'll go wake Sora up.
Riku!
Look at his face. Sleeping like nothing's wrong. Like there's nothing to even worry about. He's always been like that. The 3 of us would agree to work on the raft. And then this guy would go take a nap on the beach. You see, it's my job to keep him on his toes. Besides, what kind of Keyblade Master sleeps through his test? I'm doing it for me, too. Sora saved me once. And I heard him call my name. He needs me.
There's something real strong that binds us to each other. Even in the darkness, you can reach him. All you gotta do is follow that connection.
Gee, we're all connected to Sora.
You said it!
And if the darkness gets you, I promise I'll bail you out. Dark Rescue's my middle name.
Guys, thank you. Sora and I will be back soon.
Mm.
Oh no, I've attacked Sora. Let's get to the final boss. Yeah, believe it or not, Young Xehanort wasn't technically the final boss. He might as well have been, though. If I remember correctly, he's harder than the actual final boss. Then again, I had second chance and once more last time I did this. I only have once more.
This abyss. Am I in Sora's dream?
What?
Well, seems Ven's armor is kind of a nightmare. Balloons! Everyone loves balloons. Quickly, balloons! I expect the Phantom Blot just to come out of nowhere from Epic Mickey. Quickly! I am your guardian angel. Balloons! You know what they say, everyone loves a good balloon. Goodbye. Have balloons. Oh my. Oh. And goodbye. Yeah, way easier than Young Xehanort, that's for certain.
I'll find you, Sora.
Roxas?
What is it that you're so afraid of? Huh?
And this is the answer to these questions is how you get the secret ending. So make sure you answer in this order.
Losing something that's important. Roxas? No. Wait.
What is the one thing you care about more than anything else?
Huh? Hmm. My close friends. What is going on? Huh? Sora! Who are you?
Riku, what do you wish?
More questions. All right. I wish... to recover something important that I lost. What's this?
You were not the visitor I expected.
Diz! I mean, Ansem the Wise. What are you doing here?
Perhaps I wanted to atone for events of the past, even if no apology can undo the harm I have wrought. I felt that I ought to leave at least something behind. So I digitized myself and my research and hid them within Sora.
So this is data?
Yes. A clue, I hope, to finding yourselves or your lost friends in your hour of need. The heart has always been quick to grow. Each exposure to light, to the natural world, to other people, shapes this most malleable part inside of us. Nobodies are not different from us in that manner. Sora was the only one able to return to his human form without destroying his nobody. That is a statement to the love in his heart for other people, and the bonds that tie them together. Perhaps he has the power to bring back the hearts and existences of those connected to him, to recreate people we thought were lost to us forever. Our most precious treasures. Even an empty puppet, the trees of the forest, and the petals on the wind. There are hearts around us everywhere we look. And it does not take superhuman powers to see them. Surely we remember, as children, the way our hearts made everything seem so shiny and perfect. Sora has a heart like that, uncorrupted, willing to see the good before the bad. When he sees the heart in something, it then becomes real. When a connection seems broken, he may have the power to mend it. He has touched countless hearts. He has accepted them. And he has saved them. And some of those hearts have never left him. Whether they fell into darkness or were trapped there. Whether they sleep in the darkness of Sora's heart, or were welcomed into its warmth. They can be saved. All Sora needs to do is be himself and follow wherever it is that his heart takes him. It is the best and the only way. The rest is in there.
All right. Thanks. Thank you.
Of course. Now, why is it that you are here?
I kinda need to wake Sora up.
Don't tell me he's gone to sleep again.
Yeah. What'll I do with him?
What, indeed? Never fear. Sora is safe.
Huh?
He's not here. You see, by defeating the nightmare imprisoning Sora, you freed him.
Huh? You mean the Sora wrapped in that black phantom?
Then you came here, and you were questioned by three young people. That was the final key to awaken him. Sora is awake. You can go home now.
Really? Thank you.
Believe you ever told me your name.
It's Riku.
Sora! Huh? Hey, Donald! Come on, you're hogging it all!
Oh, calm down, Sora, I'm good
country! Of course, it sure is yummy!
Hey! Riku! You're safe! Riku!
Wait, haven't we got this backwards? And why are you having a tea party?
You're safe, Riku!
Oh, never mind. You okay? Feeling all right?
Yeah. I've never been better. I was watching what was going on in my dream. And I could hear your voice the whole time. Thanks, Riku. Thanks, everybody. Oh, yeah! Did we pass the test?
You performed truly admirably, both of you. More than anything, I am grateful to have you both back from Xehanort's deception unharmed. And I am grateful to Lee, whose spontaneous actions turned the tides. I am also deeply sorry for failing to perceive the danger and throwing you headlong into a perilous test. This experience has revealed many hidden truths, and we must gird ourselves for the great clash with darkness that lies before us. I believe we need a new Keyblade Master, one with a new kind of power. Sora and Riku, you both deserve the honor. However, one of you braved the realm of sleep again to unlock the final keyhole and save a friend. Riku, I name you our new true Keyblade Master.
Way to go, Riku!
Yeah?
I knew you were gonna pass with flying colors! This is just so awesome!
Gee, Sora, you're kind of acting like it's you that passed.
I told you Sora still needed some practice.
Hey!
Really? I'm a Keyblade Master?
Congratulations, Riku!
Thank you, Mickey. I owe it to my friends.
I'll catch up with you in no time flat.
What? You want to be a Keyblade Master?
Yeah. I mean, I came here to learn how to wield one.
You?
Hey, thanks for the vote of confidence. You know I was gonna come swooping in, Keyblade in hand. But I just couldn't get mine to materialize. Must be in the snap of the wrist or something. Huh.
Whoa!
Do you have to go?
Well, I did doze off. I just have some stuff to take care of.
Are you gonna be okay?
Yeah. I won't be long.
Be careful.
Very careful.
Right. See you soon.
All right. And there you go, ladies and gentlemen. Kingdom Hearts Dream Drop Distance, created and developed by Square Enix. Published for many systems now, and PC soon in a couple of days at the time of this recording. Alright, so my thoughts on Kingdom Hearts Dream Drop Distance. Time travel. Yeah, that's a biggie. That kind of messes with a lot of things. And for a lot of things going into Kingdom Hearts 3, it really kind of, you know, it's convoluted. Even in 3, the whole time travel thing is convoluted. Honestly, my favorite instance of time travel in the story on how the rules were set up was Ratchet & Clank Future of Kraken Time, but not everything can be in a Kraken Time, so, oh well. Anyway, where does that leave us for the Kingdom Hearts series? Well, now that we're done with Dream Drop Distance, we have 2 more games on the docket. Well, technically 3. And if I really want to go for it, I'll say 4. They are Kingdom Hearts 0.2 Birth by Sleep, A Fragmentary Passage, Kingdom Hearts 3, Kingdom Hearts Melody of Memories, and if I really hate myself, the mobile game, which is still getting story updates. So here's how I'm going to be handling the Kingdom Hearts series going forward. We're going to be doing Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep 0.2 A Fragmentary Passage next. I don't mean like, oh, it's the next Kingdom Hearts game. I mean, that's an obvious one. I mean, we are actually doing that game next. Now that this Kingdom Hearts game is done, we're doing 0.2 next. And after 0.2, we are saving Kingdom Hearts 3 for next year. Now, why am I saving Kingdom Hearts 3 for next year? Well, I had the idea because I realized it. Next year will be my 10th anniversary of doing Let's Plays. 10 years of doing Kingdom Hearts games. And how about I end it off with what the whole thing I was building up for with doing all these Kingdom Hearts games was? Kingdom Hearts 3 for the 10th anniversary of the channel. And that's what we're going to be doing for then. So, overall, Dream Drop Distance, it's okay. Story-wise, I just don't like the time travel bit. This is also marked the last time we had Leonard Nimoy voicing Master Xehanort, because he unfortunately passed after this, before 3 came out. So, it tends to happen that way. But, gameplay-wise, it's okay. The flow motion kind of gets in the way, and I should have taken off some abilities, I will admit. Some abilities were, not that good. Balloon is fun, though. All hail Balloon! May it destroy everything. Now, really, that's all I wanted to say that I can say about. There was still a lot of stuff I didn't do, but I honestly don't care. I don't care about fighting in Flick Rush, which is the only thing I really didn't show off. I do not want to fight Julius. Julius, even though that's how you get the Ultima Keyblade, if I remember correctly, is not fun with how strong he is. Yeah. So, pretty much. Yeah, see, look, Travis Town, there's Julius right there. It's like, oh god, Julius. We are going to end up doing a few more things first. Now that I have this recorded in advance enough, we will end up doing 0.2 pretty much right after this one ends, which is good. And also, before I end off with the credits, I want to thank the lovely Alpha Deus for taking a commission I had for the credit music that you are hearing right here. So, anyway, guys, I'm going to end it off right here. This has been Neuronium. I'll see you all for 0.2. We'll be right back.
Thank you. Good. I was hoping this world was still here. But where are they? There!
This world is just too small.
Sora's late. Do you think he's okay? Gorsh, Lee sure hurried back to Radiant Garden, and now Master Yen Sid's sending Riku away, too, on some mystery errand. You think we'll ever get to do something important? Oh, welcome back, Riku. Hey, wait!
The Keyblade Wars of yore plunged the true Kingdom Hearts into darkness. And the Keyblade was shattered. But the light still shining in the hearts of children rebuilt the world that we know today. And the light from the broken Keyblade was then divided into seven. To protect the number of pure hearts in the world.
Seven pure lights. They're the princesses of heart.
Indeed. Those seven pure hearts form the very source of all light in the world. If they are lost, the world will again give way to shadow. Thus, even if we deliberately avoid finding our seven lights to avert another Keyblade War, Xehanort will still target the seven princesses in order to forge the Keyblade.
So, there's gonna be a clash between seven lights and 13 darknesses? And there's nothing we can do to avoid triggering the Keyblade War?
To protect the seven pure hearts, we will need seven lights strong enough to stand against the 13 darknesses.
So we're missing one guardian of light. Riku! You're back!
That's right. Master Yen Sid, I brought you the guest you asked for, but you never said why.
Wow!
I have come to learn that you too can wield a Keyblade. I am glad you are here.
Hey, thanks for watching. If you want to check out more Kingdom Hearts content on this channel, check out the top link for a playthrough of Kingdom Hearts Recoded. And if you want to see the last main entry title of the game that was done on this channel, check out the bottom link for a playthrough of Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep Final Mix.